Hello students, today we will start a new chapter, that is financial markets. So in this chapter we will discuss about the financial markets, its concepts, functions and types. Financial markets. So in simple way we can say that a financial market is a market for creation and exchange of financial assets. Very important definition. A financial market is a market for the creation and exchange of financial asset. Means here, financial assets either are created or exchanged. Now, first of all, we would like to discuss the financial assets, the meaning of financial assets here. Financial assets means shares, debentures, bonds, etc. So it is a market where the financial assets are either created or exchanged. Or what is the meaning of either created or exchanged? If new firm will be there, then it cannot exchange its financial assets. The financial assets of a new firm can never be exchanged. So in case of new company, it is created. And for existing companies, it may be exchanged. So financial market is a market for creation and exchange of financial assets. Financial markets exist wherever a financial transaction occurs. One more definition is there. Financial market exists wherever a financial transaction occurs. Means there is no particular space, place for financial space. There is no particular space, place or circle or floor for financial market. Everywhere it is a financial market where the financial transaction takes place. So one more definition is there. Financial markets exist wherever a financial transaction occurs. Financial transactions could be in form of creation of financial assets such as initial issue or share of debentures for a new firm, and or exchange or purchase or sale of existing assets for existing companies. A business is a part of economic system that consists of two main sectors: household sector, which saves the funds, and business sector, which invests these funds. Okay, so business is a part of economic system which consists of two main sectors: household and business firms. Let's discuss one diagram here. I'll make one diagram, and with the help of diagram we will understand the business cycle. These are household sector. These are business firms. Business firms. Here we can take banks, and here we can take the financial markets. This is the diagram. This is the diagram. Business household sector, which saves the funds, common individual person, which saves the funds, and these funds are to be invested in the business firms. Means business firms needs the money, and money is saved by household sector. Business firm needs the funds for its extension growth. But there are two ways. Household sector has two ways. that they can deposit the money with the bank, and then bank will give the loan to the banks, business firms. And in this case, banks charges their major portion. For example, if we deposit 1 lakh rupees with the bank, it will give us 6% interest, means 6,000. And bank will invest in the business firms, and in return, it will get like 13,000, 13% return from the firm. So 7,000 will be the bank's commission, bank's share. Household, the money of household is invested by the bank in the business firms. The same money of household indirectly invested in the business firms, and bank is the mediocre, and bank has taken 13,000, whereas bank is paying 6,000, that is 6% to household sector. 7,000 bank is earning on household's income. So here household do not get the good return if they invest the money in the bank, and then bank invest the money in the business firms. So household can take the risk and go to the financial market, and in form of shares and debentures, they can invest the money directly in the business firms. Because in the financial market, business firms comes for funds, and household sectors, they can purchase the funds. They can purchase the financial assets. So by this way, they can get 13% return. Household can get 13% return. So this is the business cycle, and I made you understand about this business cycle. Okay, यहाँ बैंक में अगर हाउस होल्ड सेक्टर पैसे जमा करवाता है अपना सेविंग्स, तो बैंक उसको 6% 7% इंटरेस्ट देता है, और बैंक फिर फाइनेंस बिजनेस फर्म्स में लगाता है, बिजनेस फर्म बैंक से लोन लेती हैं, तो वो उनसे 13% लाइक 14% या 12% लेती हैं। तो जितना हाउस होल्ड सेक्टर नहीं कमाता, बैंक को पैसा जमा करवा के उससे ज़्यादा बैंक कमा लेता है बिजनेस फर्म्स को लोन देकर। लेकिन अगर बिजनेस हाउस होल्ड सेक्टर थोड़ा सा रिस्क लेके फाइनेंशियल मार्केट में जाता है और फाइनेंशियल एसेट्स में पैसा लगाता है, जहाँ बिजनेस फर्म्स आती हैं और अपने फाइनेंशियल एसेट्स के थ्रू फंड्स इकट्ठा करती हैं, तो दे कैन गेट 12% or 13% रिटर्न। दिस इज द इकोनॉमिक्स। हाउस होल्ड सेविंग्स अल्टीमेटली लगनी तो बिजनेस फर्म्स में ही है। इस रास्ते से जाएंगे तो 6% मिलेगा, इस रास्ते से जाएंगे तो 13% मिलेगा। सो दिस इज द फाइनेंशियल सिस्टम, दिस इज कॉल्ड फाइनेंशियल सिस्टम। नाउ वी विल डिस्कस द फंक्शंस ऑफ फाइनेंशियल मार्केट। फंक्शंस ऑफ फाइनेंशियल मार्केट्स, फंक्शंस ऑफ फाइनेंशियल मार्केट्स। नंबर वन, एलोकेटिव फंक्शन, दैट इज मीन्स मोबिलाइजिंग ऑफ सेविंग्स and channeling them to the most productive uses and channeling them to the most productive uses means is the first function of financial market, that a financial market facilitates the transfer of savings from savers to investors. It gives the savers the choice of different investments and thus helps to channelize surplus funds into the most productive uses. Means financial markets provides the best possible use of the savings of the household. By this example, financial markets can provide 13% return to the household instead of 10% return of the 6% return of the bank. So this is the first point. Second is facilitating price discovery. Price discovery. Facilitating price discovery. In the financial market, the household and suppliers of funds and business firms represent the demand. In this market, the household are the supplier of funds and business firms represent the demand. The interaction between the forces of demand and supply helps to establish a price for the financial asset being traded in the financial market. So, price of the fund is decided in the financial market. Third is providing liquidity to financial assets. Liquidity to financial assets. Financial assets means shares and debentures, etc. Financial market facilitate easy purchase and sale of financial assets. In doing so, they provide liquidity to the financial assets so that they can be easily converted into cash whenever required. Holders of the assets can readily sell these their financial assets through the mechanism of financial market. Means anytime if the investor needs the money, he can go to the financial market and sell his financial assets. So he can get converted the financial assets into cash. So liquidity can take place anytime for the financial assets through these financial markets. Fourth point is reducing the cost of transaction. Reducing the cost of transaction. Financial markets provide valuable information about the securities in the market. It helps to save time, efforts and money of both buyers and sellers of a financial assets would have to otherwise spend to try and find each other. So financial market is thus a common platform where buyer and sellers can meet for the fulfillment of their individual needs. Means financial markets provide various kind of information of the financial assets which are traded in the market, which otherwise would have to take much more time on behalf of buyers and sellers. So it reduces the cost of transaction. So students, in this video it is so far, and the next portion we will discuss in the next video. Okay, bye.